Control for. I can tell you that I will sign the oath, support the Constitution of the United States and the state of Michigan and the rights of every member of Douglas Township. I will look at things from a technical perspective, and I can tell you right now, the citizens ordinance is technically wrong. I can tell you that if you reduce a wind turbine, those decibels that everybody's worried about, EMRs and everything else, only brings it closer to the occupants. So I will look at things honestly, fairly, and ethically. There's people in this room that will attest to my integrity, and I am appalled that you are all making assumptions and you don't even know who I am.
Talk to the board.
Yeah, thank you.
Terry, about back to the Spicer group, you said she lied. She called you a liar. She didn't. That is a lie that you made up. Because she didn't. We have it on tape. Were you lying about that? Yes. I've listened to the tape. She did not. You got defensive. I wonder why. She and many others also asked, who is paying for the Spicer group? Several times they asked. Two separate meetings. And all you could say was, we don't know. And Rhonda said, I haven't paid them. Well, Ron Reddick threw you under the bus when he said the township is paying them. Or was he lying? We already know he's inadequate at his job. He's made that clear. So are they lying? Not telling the truth, or are they inadequate at your job? Any one of three is despicable, and you should resign. The board has also been asked many times by many citizens, do we have liability insurance? Clear back in January, we started asking. Since way back, same answer, we don't know. Not a single person on that board could or would answer whether we had insurance or liability. How many people here don't know if they have insurance or how much you even pay? Lying? Are you not telling the truth, or are you just inadequate in your job?
Pretty much.
Yep. I'm not calling you liars, but if they aren't, then you're very inadequate in your job. You should resign. Now you want to replace two of the best PC members we've had. Why? Because you've been embarrassed by them. They know their stuff. They've done their research. They're intelligent. They're listening to the citizens, which you are, even though you said you would, and all because they don't agree with you. And because he wants turbines on his property. How do I know that? You told me that. Last January, you told me you wanted to put them on the property on Hillis Road, but it didn't look good if you signed up. I didn't think it'd look good if the supervisor was signed up. Then you laughed. I've got that in tape. He also got all bent out of shape a couple months ago and was mad about some rumors that was going around about him being signed up, shaking his fingers at us once again and yelling, I haven't signed up yet.
Yeah.
Thank you. The insults he's called many of us, especially Sheila and Cindy, because they've literally made him look foolish, are totally uncalled for. You say they should be in Pine Rest, calling this one and that one a bitch and a dildo, among other names. This is no way for our officials to talk. I call for your resignation.
Yeah.
Several officials around the county that you think are your buddies. And they're all getting quite a kick out of your sideshows and bullying and having the police at the board meetings. The consensus was, let him look like the fool. We will look like the heroes when it's all done. They're right. If these things come in and real estate plummets, people move away. For generations to come, they will not blame Apex, but they'll blame the selfish officials that only cared about their own pocketbook. What a legacy you're going to leave.
My name is Melissa Bannon. I have property in Douglas Township and Pine Township, and I do go to every meeting I can think of because there's 750 feet tall from everywhere. There's 285 parcels that have signed up. That's 285 little pieces of property. Some people can't build a turbine, some people can. This is throughout the whole county. That's not very many people. So that means 90% of us don't want them. We want safety. We don't want to look out our side yards and see a turbine at our side. We want to be able to build on our property. We don't want them to infringe on our property. We don't want the noise. We don't want the height. We don't want the sound. We don't want the health issues. But all of a sudden, you work for those 10% people. Because I think 285 is gonna end at 286, correct? Do you work for Ron Reddick or do you work for us? You stacked the deck. You took everybody off that were great, wonderful people that have done their jobs for years so that Terry Anderson could get his own way. You are shameful, you're an embarrassment. And I know you don't believe the big companies. You told me that yourself. But all of a sudden, you're kissing a person from out of town that's gonna come in and destroy this community. There'll be no schools because everybody will move out. There'll be no farm to come visit because nobody will wanna come see it. You don't understand in 10 years, people, if you can look at a magic ball and realize what this damage will do to you. But all you see is the green money. All you see is I'm gonna have money in my pocket. You don't see this tiny little baby next to me, what you're leaving the land to. He's not going to have any land left because you guys are going to ruin it all by putting these monstrous things on it. And shame on you. I hope you can go home and look in the mirror and be proud of what you have done to this community.
We will. It's funny, ain't it, Tom?
Yep.
Pretty funny, Tom.
Hi, I'm Lori Herzl, Douglas Township. I've attended many meetings and I've heard all the rhetoric and everything going on. And I understand the farmer's plight because I know your job is very hard and I appreciate what you do. But I live over on Clifford Lake and all summer long I put up with planes crop dusting and spraying poisonous chemicals that blow over into my windows. And yet I don't say anything because I have no choice. You have a choice of what you put on your property. We don't. Just like when you decide to crop dust, I don't have any choice. And you can't tell me that it's not harmful because Greenville and that area had the highest levels of testicular cancer from the potato pesticides that were put on the potato crop, and it leaked into the groundwater. And that's it. So that's a given. But I have to put up with that. And I don't have any choice. But you have a choice how you use your property. I have a medical condition. And, you know, I may be one of many, but blinking lights, light flicker will send me. I have a nerve condition in my head. And I've lived for 40 years with extreme nerve pain and things like that. I'm light sensitive. And the thought of having to leave my property that I love because I can't be around, you know, have a light flicker. Because they're going to supposedly put three of them across the street from where I live. I just, it's not funny. It's not funny. But when they're that tall and the sun is over on the south side, you don't get up. And Terry, the community has been very supportive of you and your business. And you, and this is what you're doing, you in turn are not supporting what the majority of the people in your community do not want. We do not want these turbines. We don't want our community ruined. You know what? The last 2 years have been hard on all of us with this COVID pandemic and everything else, and look what's happened. Everybody's turned against each other. And the corruption, not only on the state level, but the national level. Now we have corruption on the local level. When is it ever gonna end? Why, where's the integrity here with people? Where's integrity and honesty? What has happened to everybody? Wait, you know, we're just at each other's, we're just calling each other names? Why can't we just do what's right? Why can't you represent the people that elected you to this position? The majority of us do not want these.
Time to
go. All right.
Kevin?
Yes, I'm on the PC, Kevin Rush. I'd just like to say, I think we live in a very unique area. We have the beauty of forests, streams, lakes, beautiful farmland, even I'll even say beautiful orchards as we do. I can go over on Tittabawassee, one area, you can still look around. A 100 wind turbines, the biggest ones there are. Would you, any of you like a flashing light in your bedroom all night long? On and off, on and off, on and off. Once they come in and destroy our unique beauty here, nobody mentions not just about the health problems and liquor and the destruction of the environment. Nobody mentions the studies. I don't hear much about that. But that's our unique area we live in. And once that you take that away, it's gone forever. You will never get that back in this community. I'm ashamed of rhetoric for 150 foot. And you sit here and try to advise us differently. Yeah. I'm ashamed of a lot of people in our community that just want to line their pockets. Just a handful of people to destroy our unique area we live in when the biggest percentage of the people don't want it. And things are done purposely, people can see it, just to get their way. We will never get that back after you bring these in. Then it'll never be the same in their whole county. You can go over there and it's just sickening to see. Most people over there don't like it. Property values proven go down. It's just horrible. Everything about this is horrible. Big corporations come in, always, oh, it's going to benefit everybody, bring in big money. If we did that with all the oceans, all the mountains, heck, they tried to sabotage people, big money. Oh, it's going to bring in income, jobs. Do we always have to have that? Do we always have to destroy our environment and the beauty we live in just to line a few pockets? Absolutely ridiculous.
Originally from Ionia. And my point is the fact that I hear a lot of the talk about safety, health, and welfare. We have a gentleman that's trying to make something so his daughter could be taken care of when he passes away and people make fun of him. We have people that try to stare you down and call you names, which I'm guilty of. I'm not even going to deny it. But then we also have these that were the silent majority that showed up tonight, which I want to thank each and every one of you. But the reason why we haven't been in very many meetings is we're working. I haven't been able to be at any meetings for the last 2.5 months because of the fact that we've had employee issues and we've been doing things on the farm in which we've needed everybody to be there later than what we usually do. And people say, go get a second job. I work 60 hours a week. What other second job am I going to get? And then we have people saying, well, don't talk to the crowd, talk to the board. Those are the ones that are performing for the crowd, are the ones that are seen to be yelling the loudest. And I know that everybody's picking on Mr. Rhetoric, but where he lives is not where we live. There's a whole different thing there than what we've got here. They did all the research there, and they'll do the research here on the birds, on the bats, on the eagles, and all that environmentally stuff that people are complaining about and mentioning. The thing is, people just don't want it here. And they're not going to deny that because they're making everything so hard for it to be here. They don't want it here. But the people that want it here can yell just as loud, can be just as rowdy. But we are trying to take the higher road.
Eric Tester, I don't even like coming to these meetings. I wish Apex would have never walked in the door. I see what this has done. You know, you talked about removing people. Laura, you're my postmaster for years. How did you know they were already removed people? I've been to the meetings. They never said anything about it. And all of a sudden, in the middle of the night, this guy's gone, that guy's gone. You're taking some of the best people in this community. we gotta have a better way. We just can't throw people away because they're not looking at it our way. You know, I didn't know the last election that you guys been talking to Apex for 4 years, that this was in the stages. I voted for everybody on this board except for Pat. I don't know who he is. I had a lot of confidence in you guys. Right now, I don't have any confidence, and it scares me. I put my name on these things before to be on boards. I'm the only person here that has relatives that have built wind farms in Michigan. I don't even get a call. You guys wondering what goes on at the boards or at the meetings. Most of you don't even show up. We're the only ones showing up at every meeting. I mean, you're supposed to be representing us. You all should have been to the meeting getting your viewpoint. You know, is this building a better community? Does it look like it? One thing I don't like, I grew up on a farm. I spent a lot of years working for local farmers. I don't have a lot. I don't want to lose it because they put termites around it. And that's what's going to happen. I don't hear anything about, I'm all for people making money off their land, but I'm also looking at, we're looking at the richest of people among us that this is going to benefit. It's not going to benefit the little guy. We're not doing this for the poor. This is going to destroy the little guy. When you can't sell your house, you got migraine headaches. I talked to you guys before about how do we compensate losses. You said maybe we could put it in the bill. In the last year, no one even says anything about losses, like they're just going to disappear. This is destroying a community, and I wish you could see it.
I think it's horrible. But we're forgetting the fact that we all need electricity.
We have it.
We get it from those kids right away.
It's not that green as you think.
Yeah. And the president doesn't want it either, right?
Yeah.
Go Brandon.
Three rich people are going to get rich.
I spoke to Terry Anderson last winter about my concerns on the phone. His words were to me were, Brandy, do not worry. We will do what the majority of the people want. Kathy Craig did a little investigation and reported at the last PC meeting that public comments at the Douglas meetings for the entire last year were overwhelmingly against large-scale wind energy systems in the township. Of the 292 total documented comments regarding wind turbines, 216, or 74% of them, were against them. 53, or 18%, were for them, but out of the 53, 13 of those, or 25%, were from Apex employees themselves. Taking Apex comments out of the equation, only 40 comments, or 14%, were for the turbines. 74% against. And these numbers do not count the last PC meeting, where I believe not a single person in the large audience was in favor of the turbines. Do not worry. We will do what the majority of the people want. Do you remember that conversation? Terry, protection from these turbines, and in most cases, no turbines at all, is clearly what the people want. But since the minute you gave me your word, and the majority of the township has spoken against them, you are doing everything in your power to battle us. In fact, replacing wonderful PC members is exactly not doing what you told me you would. The board has final approval on an ordinance, so while you admit you are replacing the PC members to get the ordinance you want, I'm not sure if you meant to admit that, it wasn't necessary to get the ordinance you want, and you know that. This was underhanded and dirty. Not only have these PC members listened to the citizens, but they also did exactly what you asked them to do. You asked them to bring you an ordinance. So if you were listening to the citizens as you gave me your word you would, you'd be working with us to come up with the protective terms, which Ron clearly approves of with his 150 feet,
yeah.
Not scheming and undermining some of the best people we have in the township that we're serving on the PC board. Cindy and Kevin, thank you for everything you've done for the township. Your legacy will remain high as you are doing what you're supposed to do, what all the board members are supposed to do, looking out for the health, safety, and welfare of the township. That is the oath. Finally, for a couple of the other board members up there who haven't been as outwardly hostile toward us, please do what is right for the oath of health, safety, and welfare. Silence is consent, and I believe history will not view the board who forever ruined the township in a favorable light. Thank you.
He
Ann Hemmes, Montcalm Township. I support much of what's been said here tonight, and we are a county. That's why many of us come to other meetings, because other townships are going to affect us also. First of all, I mean, it kind of blows me away that Mr. Reddick can say 150 feet. I know it's been said over and over again, but that he can actually bring those words out of his mouth when he helped to pass 150-foot height limit in his own township because of migratory birds. We have many, many pathways of migratory birds in Michigan. We have so, through our township, we have so many lakes, streams, creeks. They love us here. I lived near a little lake, and I was on a walk, and practically the whole lake, Turk Lake, Back Turk Lake, was covered with migratory geese. I mean, it's shocking. We have so many. Mr. Anderson and the board, I think what you did here tonight with your PC members was absolutely un-American. Mm-hmm. Un-American. That's what I think. And in terms of Mr. Smucker brought up property rights, and man, I agree with the gal over here that lives on Clifford Lake. I respect the farmers. My dad, I visited many farms growing up. My dad was an area veterinarian. My family, my dad was a farmer in his youth. My family were all farmers. And I am not against wind turbines in general, but the reason we don't want them here is because they don't fit in a rural residential area with safe placement. You know, we might be able to have two or three or four in our county placed safely. Apex's idea of what's safe is ridiculous, and why you guys believe them is beyond me. There's just as much research saying about the infrasound and about the other vibrational things and the flicker. That research is out there too, and that research is also on PubMed. I'm just stunned that you would do this tonight. I am just stunned. And I just have to say one more time, un-American.
Yes. City Township. Mr. Anderson, you used to be a supervisor here. You were elected a supervisor. You started listening to the puppet show of APEC, buying their Kool-Aid, and now all of a sudden became a dictator. Why that is, I don't know. You're not supposed to be a dictator. You're supposed to be a supervisor to represent the people here. And it's obvious the people do not want turbines. But yet, you and your dictatorship decided to change things for your way. Well, your way is not going to work, sir. It's the majority of the people. The majority of the people put you there. You work for the majority. You don't work for the traveling salesmen, APEC, of these people. You work for the majority. And why you would choose these traveling salesmen over your community, your neighbors, generation after generation of neighbors, even your own family members, they're all opposed to this. For what? Your personal gain? Because you want to be a dictator? Is that what it is, sir? Come on. And you say you don't lie? You have many lies. Sydney Township's not getting sued. You said they were. Dude, you're being called out in the worst way. And you are a dictator. Thank you, Joe Hanson.
Hearing all kinds of stuff. I've got like a million gazillion things going through my head. You, property rights, let me tell you property rights. Right now, at this minute, across the street from an apple orchard that gets sprayed by a whole lot of chemicals, and I do have the list. You know those chemicals, the fungicides and the pesticides that get sprayed on the apples? You shouldn't be spraying them around lakes. People who go on the property should be there within 24 hours and have covers. I have the information on that stuff. I was concerned about my animals. Back to the property rights. I live in this township. I bought a 17-acre piece of shit. Garbage all over it. Land is awful. Fixed it up, busted my butt, took tons of trash out of there that the township allowed to come because, you know, there were no rules, of course. I have a 511-foot house. sitting in my driveway right now. I got all my permits. I'm not allowed to have that. I can't live in that house. Why? Because it's 511 feet. My husband and I, we live in a mobile home, 980 foot right now, that is falling apart. And we don't use but half of that trailer, half of it. Half of that trailer is not used at all. It's fine though, because I have wasted space. 511 foot mobile home, or a house. I have to add 200 more foot, 229 more feet on, taking green space from my yard, because I'm not allowed to live. I am not allowed to live with my husband in a 511 foot house. Why? What? Why? That is my property. Why should I not be allowed to do that? It's a nice house. It's passing inspections. Everything that it was Amish built. It's a nice house. But I'm not allowed to because the rule says, there's rules all over this township. 113 pages of them, please know. So having turbines, my little 511 foot house is not disturbing anybody. Nobody. But yet your 600 foot turbines, we want to negotiate, I negotiate. 300 foot, there we go, negotiation. Yeah. Half your side, half my side, we're ready to go. But this is ridiculous. You do tell me what to do. Yeah. You've told me where I could put my shed. Cement pad right there. I was told I wasn't allowed to have it there. Then I had to pay the township $10 because their building department guy at that point didn't know what she was doing. Then I turn around and I have to pay $250 to see if they would let me have the shed. And then they said, yeah. And then Mr. Anderson, this blew my mind. Well, I drove by your house every day. I should have stopped. Yeah, it would have been nice. So, am I afraid? Y'all saying you're afraid? I am terrified to speak up because Mr. Anderson is my neighbor. His turbines from those frost turbines irritate the holy heck out of me when he has to run them, and he don't run them much. But I'll tell you what, I do hear in our bedroom. They are, 50 or 60 feet tall. I hear them when they're running. My neighbor hears them when they're running. We thought there was a helicopter. Thank you.
I'm only a jerk.
Brandy. He wanted to talk.
Yeah,
he said he wanted to talk. Yeah, he said he wanted
to talk. No, because they didn't be reading.
They just ended. Got it. He didn't even have a chance to.
He didn't even have a chance. Like, he was going to say, is there anyone else?
And then, Tom just said, I moved to adjourn this meeting.
They did get finished the vote.
I'm trying to get a comment from Terry, too.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.